A little bit of action now. This is a trick now with a full ice. First of all, I was the spades, I was the dark, and I said, no. I put three different cards here. On there like that.
Not like that.
Thank you, sir. And three different cards on here like that. And I'm acting all the time now. Three different go on here. Odd number. Between 1 and 4. Give me a number. Give me one, four. Three. He said three. That was your choice. Three. All right. Put there the other. 1, 2, 3. Put them in there. Close the lid like that. Then you get three cards like this. Look. Three cards. The ace of clubs. All right. I turn the ace of clubs over. I go like that. And there's the queen there, like there. Queen of spades. Six clubs and the ace of clubs. Four. Ace of spades, three different cards there like that. I turn the ace of spades over. I go, doop. I'll go 1, 2, 3, and the ace of spades gone. And last but not least, the ace of hearts, three different cards there like that. And I tell you what, I don't know what language it is, do you? I turn the ace of hearts over. And I've got 1, 2, 3, and the ace of hearts gone. So the ice of spades, ice of clubs, and ice of clubs are gone. And I open the box, and I take them out of here. And here are the four ices. Strawberry ice, peppermint ice, vanilla ice, and raspberry ice. Thank you. Thank you very
much. Cooper, the new waiter.
Ah, yes, of course, Cooper. Do come in through that door, would you? Yes.
I spoke to you on the telephone this morning.
Yes, that's right, sir.
I am the head waiter.
Oh, yes.
You know, of course, that the Flamingo is one of the most exclusive restaurants in the world.
Yes, I know that, sir. Yes.
Oh, you know that?
Yes. Well, I used to be very wealthy.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You lost your money? Uh-huh. Gambling too much?
No, I ate here too much. It was cheaper to eat money.
Yes, yes. Well, you have had some experience of our standard of service, hmm?
Oh, yes, I have, sir. I think it's fair. I don't know how you do it.
Well, we all have our little secrets, you see, Cooper. Because, you see, no matter how nasty things get out there in the restaurant, they do get very nasty indeed. People become very rude and overbearing and demanding. Each and every waiter knows they can come in here and let off steam. Shout, curse, scream, throw little china things up the wall. And we'd like you to look upon this as your friendly room.
Friendly room?
Yes. Yes. Thank you. You see, no matter how nasty things get out there, you must, Cooper, keep smiling. Because in here, you can do as you like. Is that understood?
Yes, sir. I mean, out there is a nasty room where I have to be nice.
Yes.
And in here is the nice room where I can be nasty.
Well, yes, roughly speaking, yes. We'd like you to look upon this as your friendly room.
Friendly room?
Yes. Thank you, yes. You seem a bit over-anxious.
I am a bit, yes.
A bit nervous?
Yes.
A bit tense?
Hmm? A little bit, yes.
Would you like to relieve your tension a bit?
Yes, all right.
Of course. Well, then, have a scream and a throw.
Can I have a throw and a scream?
By all means.
All right.
Ah! Ah! Oh! Splendid, splendid. Now are you feeling any better?
Marvellous. All the noodles and knowledge have done my spine have all loosened up.
Ah, you're lovely. Yes, of course. Well, have another one.
Can I?
Oh, of course.
Jack, I'll do that all night.
Yes, wonderful. Would it? Well, any time you feel like it. Any time you feel like it at all. But remember, Cooper, and this is very important, in the restaurant, it's always the smile and the whisper. Whisper, whisper, yes. Please don't keep doing that.
Well, yeah, I thought you said it was a friendly room.
Yes, of course. Well, now, Cooper, carry on, Cooper.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck, Cooper.
Thank you.
And, Cooper, check your smile in the smiling mirror as you go out. Splendid. Oh, and Cooper. Cooper, the whisper. Whisper, whisper, whisper.
Waiter.
Yes, sir.
Any danger of any service?
I'm sorry, Mr. Belay. I've just come on duty, sir. I wonder if you'd like to look at the menu while you order some drinks.
We'll have two gin and tonics and don't take all night about it. I know that menu off by heart, you know. I can tell you exactly what's for starters, what's for main course and what's for sweets. I don't need to look at it. You
excuse
have what
me,
you like. You can have the caviar, you can have the smoked salmon, you can have the salad and east wine, anything you like.
Get it off your chest.
Oh, I was going to have the oysters, but there isn't an hour in the month.
Oh, you don't have to worry about that here, sir.
April is over. There isn't an hour in the month.
Well, it doesn't matter here, sir, because April follows Ray, Rune, and Realizes.
I don't want any funny remarks, just service.
Yes, sir. I wonder if the madam would like some prawns in aspic.
I'll say what we're going to have.
Oh, no, dear, he's only trying to be helpful.
You shut it. They're pushing the leftovers on us. I know. No wonder all the waiters are foreign. English waiters are diabolical. He is typical of them. They give you no service, and they want a whacking great tip at the end of a long drink of water like this. I won't let them get anything over me. I eat here regularly. I not only eat here, I eat in every restaurant in London, the big ones, the little ones, everyone. It's in my job. I'll eat one.
Well, I'm liking it from him. Anyone like him? No.
Splendid! Yes! That's right! Oh, let me off my chest! You're a splendid cook. Just one moment.
What?
That's my wine glass you just threw.
Who cares?
All these things on the table, and you have to throw my wine glass. Get me another one.
I thought you said it was a friendly room. Get it yourself.
Well, mate. Waiter, waiter. Luke, I owe you an apology. I was a bit rude earlier on.
That's right, sir. Yes.
You know, you didn't mean it.
Of course. Shut it. You're doing a grand job, lad, and we will have the oysters. Ah, right, thank you. You got it. Well, you know. Yes.
There you are! Where's my wine glass?
You want some wine, sir?
Wine? I have some wine. I want my wine glass.
Would you like some oysters, sir?
Oysters? Oysters? Who's talking about oysters? There's no R in the month. I just want my wine glass. Get me my wine glass, you swine!
Certainly, sir. The swine will get you your wine glass. Straight away, sir. The swine will get your wine glass. The swine will get your wine glass!
Now, look here. Yes. As far as I'm concerned, your reputation as a high-class restaurant is over. I don't know whether you are aware who I am, but you soon will be. Here is my card. Come on, June. Oh. You. Just get. Come on. Yes.
Cooper.
Oh.
Do you know who that was?
No idea.
That was Sir Parsimony Fried. The international gourmet. That's who that was.
Parsimony Fried?
Yes.
Well, I didn't know that. I got all confused, you see. Yes. Because all this is going on, just because I thought this was the nasty where I had to be nice. And then there was the nice where I could be nasty. You know what I mean? And I got confused. And I was nasty in both rooms, you see.
Shut up! You're fired! Yes. No. In here. Now then. Once and for all, Cooper, in here you can do what you like.
In here I can do what I like?
Yes.
Do you want a good laugh?
Yes, take that.
A waiter.
Come in.
Now, tonight, Tom, we're going to ask you some questions on behalf of our viewers and find out, as it were, your innermost thoughts. So I'll ask you the first question now, which says, does Tommy Cooper believe in metempsychosis?
Do you know, it's funny you asked me that, because a man asked me that two or three days ago.
Yes.
And, pardon?
But what I'm trying to get at is this. Do you think that on Earth, everyone has a double?
I had a double just before the show.
No. I don't mean that. I mean, do you mean that we all have somebody who looks exactly like us?
No one could look like you, I tell you.
That's nice, isn't it? That really is nice. I know what you think. You think that we were all born before. You think that we're all born before as someone else.
That I believe.
Right, all right. Well, who were you before you were Tommy Cooper?
Well, I got a feeling I was a Viking slave on a galley ship.
Really? Well, what makes you think that?
Because my back aches. And another thing, never mention the word whip, because you'll get me rowing straight away.
Whip?
You should have done it. You see, you've got me going now.
Look, how do I stop you?
You can't. You can never stop the galley slaves now. Once they start, they keep rowing and rowing and rowing until they drop. Look at them. They're all dropping. They're all dying like flies.
Well, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm the lucky one.
Why is that?
Well, they forgot to give me a whore.
Land ahoy!
Oh, thank goodness for that.
Well, that was a welcome rest, wasn't it?
It was, certainly was.
It's quite obvious from that story that you were there in those days.
Oh, yes.
But I'd like to see a little evidence if you have some.
All right, well, as a matter of fact, I have it right here, look.
Oh, well, that's a Viking horse, a genuine Viking
yes.
horse.
Yes, oh, yes. Listen. Doesn't sound much, does it?
No.
But 5 minutes from now, this place will be full of Vikings.
Well, in that case, I think we'd better say goodnight.
I think you're right, yeah. I know, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to produce 2,000 ducks. Ducks. In 20 seconds.
Theater.
We got a good job. We look after it.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm producing ducks.
Producing ducks on my stage? This is the New London Theatre, not Everdale Farm. Now get them off at once. Will you get these ducks off the stage?
I'll leave him. Sorry.
Get a duck expert, but get him at once.
I certainly will.
Right.
Is there a duck expert here?
Yes, I am.
Well...
What are you doing here?
Look at the audience. Smile. Right, get that duck off.
Get the duck... But if we don't have this stage clear of ducks in 5 minutes, you're out of this theater of air.
Well...
Come on.
Right, off. Can I get that to you, sir? And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to... Now, what I'd like to do now for me... I'd like to show you now a wonderful illusion, a wonderful trick. The very famous... the very famous magic kettle. Now, from this kettle, I shall pour any drink you call for. Any drink you call for. From this magic kettle.
Ha ha ha!
She's gone start raving mad.
Any drinks poured from the tent? No, from the skin. What would you like, sir? A beer?
Beer? Would you like a beer?
Like a beer,
there?
Sir? Right, here we are. Look, from the magic kettle of beer. A pint of beer.
Oh!
Oh! Here we are, sir. Now, would you give that to... What would you like, sir? Beer?
Mm. Would you take that to the gentleman? Gin and tonic.
A gin and tonic.
One gin and tonic.
Right, gin and tonic coming up. Just taste that. Make sure it's genuine. Whiskey.
Yes, a whiskey.
Is it genuine? Is it genuine?
There you are, for that lady down there.
A whiskey.
A whiskey.
Here we are.
Scotch whiskey.
Scotch whiskey.
One genuine Scotch whiskey. Mmm. Lovely. Could we have a...
I'll give you a little Welsh whiskey now. It is Welsh whiskey. Look, it's got a leak in it. Anything else you would like?
Yes, I'd like a Drambuie shandy, please.
A Drambuie shandy?
Oh, this is lovely.
Is there anything else you want?
Yes, I want a packet of crisps.
A packet of... Well, before you have the packet of crisps, I'll tell you what I want you to do. I want you to go and get changed.
What's that?
For this wonderful big trick, wonderful big illusion.
What big illusion?
I'll tell you what it is. This very big illusion is the very famous motorbike trick.
Oh, ah.
Very dangerous. Oh. Would you go off, please, to get changed?
Yes.
For this wonderful, big illusion.
Oh, OK.
The motorbike
trick. Oh, the motorbike trick. Oh, all right.
Off you go.
Someone wants the kettle.
Somebody wants the kettle? Right, all right, then. Who wants this kettle as a souvenir? So they're giving that dinner down there. No, you got the wrong bite, darling. I'll take it off. I want the big one, see?
Sorry.
Take it off.
OK.
Come on, then.
We'll get the big one now.
Ladies and gentlemen, now, this is where it comes to this wonderful big illusion, a wonderful big trick, where she will drive up that ramp very slowly, quietly. And when she gets inside this crate here, the crate will go slowly in the air. Slowly in the air, and when I clap my hands, she will disappear. If the wind is in the right direction. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Right. The very famous deftified trick. In there and disappear. Right, ready? He's coming down. Come on in. Are you ready?
Magical Cooper.
What are they doing?
Magical Cooper.
Let's turn it up.
Magical Cooper.
Yes.
Oh, it's you.
Yes.
This is it, Robbie. Yes, this is what we've got. Okay, carry on.
Right. A Texan walks into a bar, you see.
Okay, I'll tell him.
I'll tell him.
No hat.
No hat?
No hat.
Well, it helps a joke.
No, but it shadows the face. Elbow the hat.
All right.
Okay. What's that?
So this Texan walks
What's
into...
What's that?
It's a hat. You said elbow the hat,
Yes, but I don't mean put your elbow in the hat, do I? Elbow! Get rid of the hat! Tell the joke!
Right.
I'm here to help you.
Right you are, then.
Get on with the joke.
Right. Well, this Texan walks into a bar, you see, without a hat. And he had a big, big nose. And when I say a big, big nose, it was a big, big nose!
Hold it.
Right.
Hold it. Yes. Yes. Is that in the joke?
There wasn't. He had a big, big nose. And you said, hold it.
We haven't got time to ad lib, Lovely. Just do the joke.
Right.
Just the joke.
Right.
All right?
Yes, all right.
Go.
So he walked in this bar,
camera
big,
one.
Big nose. And he put his foot on the footrail.
Camera two.
Camera two. He put his foot...
Camera three.
Camera three. He put his foot on the footrail.
Hi, camera.
Hi, camera.
Back to one.
Back to one. So he put his foot on the footrail. And
do you know this joke or not?
Yes, well, I'm trying to tell it. I know, I'm trying to tell it. You keep walking all over there like that, around there like that.
Just, it's
not. It's not for you, but I don't know where I'm
going
like
nerves.
That all the time like that. How would you like to keep doing that all the
don't,
time?
Don't
like
worry.
That?
Don't worry, son, it happens to them all. Just do the joke.
You still there?
Yes,
right,
I'm here,
I'm here. All right, I'll do the joke.
Right, do the joke.
So, he walked in this...
Try it over here.
So the Texan...
Too much light here, Robbie. Yes, carry on with the joke.
All right, and he said to the barmaid, see?
Yes, it's too much glare here, I think. Carry on with the joke, the joke.
So he said to the barmaid...
I can stick a lamp up here.
I can stick a lamp up here. No, he didn't say that. I just
what do you say it for, then?
Well, I never said it before. I don't know why I said it. Stick it out.
Look, will you try and get it right, son? Look, just keep on these marks.
Yes.
Don't move off the mark.
Right.
I'm here to help.
Right.
Do the joke!
Oh! Well, this Texan walked into the bar, you see, and he said to the barmaid, can I stick my big nose up on your bar rails? Without moving off the mark. No, I don't know.
Hold it, hold it.
I've got all the pieces. I don't know what I'm talking about now.
You'll have to make a cut in this joke.
Well, I've got a piece, I've got a piece, I can't help it.
Well, just get to the end. What do you do at the end?
Oh, I get to the end.
Get to the end.
I walk on.
Yeah.
I walk on.
Yes.
All right, give me time.
Well, you're on.
I walk on. Did you just say cut the joke?
Yes.
Right, I'll cut it. I walk on, you see. And I say, now I'm going to do the impossible, which has never been done on television before.
Great. What's impossible?
Trying to do this bleeding joke. I say, I mean, Charlie, my brother-in-law, he's looking after the business. It's my first holiday for 25 years. See, look, Charlie look after the business for a change. Oh, that son. Charlie look after the business. I must be starting to remember, he's an idiot. An idiot, that's what he is. Fancy me. Like, what a fool I am. I'm a fool to myself. Let me look after the business. I'm going to get back. I'm going to go home. That's all right. I'm going back. I'm going home. I'm going to get back straight away. I'm going back. No, he's all right. No, Charlie's all right. Of course he's all right. I'm going to join him. He said he had phoned, didn't he? There's the phone. He said he had phoned. There's the phone there. He said he had phoned. He was in trouble. He did, didn't he? Yes, he did. Well, relax. I am. I'm going to. So shut up, then. All right, I will shut up. I'm just going to enjoy myself. I really am. I've forgotten how to enjoy myself. That's my trouble. I've forgotten how to enjoy myself. But I'm going to enjoy myself, I tell you that. While I'm enjoying myself, I think I'll take a photograph of myself. Yes, do that. I will. I think I'll play some music.
C'est votre fameux et favori disque jockey qui vous parle. Aujourd'hui, la température est de 38 degrés et le ciel est bleu. Attention au coup de soleil. La police nous annonce une formidable queue de voiture sur l'autoroute du Sud.
Oh, shut up. I'm going to enjoy myself, I am. And the doctor said to me, you've got to relax. That's what he said. What else did he say? £50. That's right, that's what he said. £50. Just relax. I think I'll walk up and down a bit. I spoke with the guy at the same time. I woke up and down a bit. I was determined to enjoy myself. I think I'll read the paper as well. What's that? Mass unemployment? Famous people forced to take jobs abroad? What are they trying to do? Make me feel guilty? Come on, everybody read this. Look, famous people forced to seek odd jobs abroad. Look.
Don't believe all you read in the papers, mate. Sacre bleu! Oh. I just remember I have forgotten to put the garlic in my souffle. Oh.
It wasn't, was it?
If I rule the world!
No, it wasn't. Oh, yes, it was. I'll take his advice. I won't read the papers. Always bad news. I'll sit down and enjoy myself.
There is a call from London, Mr. Cooper.
A call from London? Charlie's in trouble. I'll take it on here. Say, Charlie. I wasn't a bit of props here. What's the matter? Hello? Charlie? In trouble? No? Oh, good. I'm very pleased about that, Charlie. How's business? Great? Oh, lovely. Oh, that's fine. Another big deal yesterday? Oh, lovely. Oh, that's fine. You don't need me home then? No? Oh, good. I could stay another week? Oh, lovely. All right, Charlie. I can stay another week.
Good evening, Tom.
Hello, David.
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to Fez to Fez, a probing searchlight into the creative matrix of a genius. Now, Tommy, would you agree that the quintessential element of comedy is, as Bergson says, l'amour propre du maladroit?
Who's this? A Chinaman?
Maybe I should translate. L'amour propre du maladroit means that the funny people are those who are out of step with life. Or maybe you'd agree with Baudelaire, who says there's no value in a practical demonstration.
An Indian looking for a squaw.
Or could you put it another way?
Yeah, I could put it another way. Mickey Mouse, looking for his other ear.
Put it another way. Put it another way. Would you say that there is one common ingredient in all human comedy, and would you attempt an analysis?
I'll have a go at it, of course.
Ah, good. Well, then we agree. We agree that risibility is incorporated in social modes which could easily vanish.
Yes, just like this boon. Vanish!
Then, of course, there's... There is another saying that the visual element is an important ingredient in all comedy. Can
yes.
you recall it?
Yeah, I'll try to bring it back.
May I say...
Remember Pathy News? He's still alive.
Tommy, may I say thank you very much, and may I say it's been a refreshing change to have a really intelligent conversation with you. Thank you very much.
Anytime you like.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night. Good night.